Welcome to this transcriptive tutorial going over clip mode. Clip mode is another one of the new features in Transcriptive 2.0. Clip mode lets you transcribe your individual media files and then view, edit, and work with those transcripts. This lets you load any file in your project and quickly lets you search through the transcript, and you can transcribe a bunch of footage and then use those transcripts to build sequences, which I'll show how to do in this video. To activate clip mode, click this clip mode switch at the top of Transcriptive. When the switch is set to the right, Transcriptive will load the transcript for the active clip or let you transcribe that clip. So I'm going to load up a clip here that doesn't have a transcript and I can transcribe it. I can select what speech engine I want to use, see the length of the clip, the cost, and set the language. And then when I transcribe it, it's going to send that clip to the speech engine I selected and return the transcript when it's done. Once the transcript completes, it comes back attached to this clip. If I switch to another clip and switch back, the transcript will be there. The transcript is saved in a couple places. First, it's saved to the clip's metadata, which you can see in the metadata panel in Premiere if you scroll down to Speech Analysis. This is the original version of the transcript as it was transcribed without any edits. So if you ever need to load the original transcript for one of your clips, it's always going to be stored in the speech analysis. Transcripts are also saved in a sidecar file, which you can find in the same location as your clips on your drive. The transcript is going to be named the same name as your clip and then underscore transcript.json. When you switch to your clip, this is the file that loads into the transcriptive panel, and this file also saves any edits that you make to the text. So if you go in here and change some words, correct some spelling, those changes are all going to be saved to that file. So when I switch to another transcript and then switch back, all those changes are going to be saved. So clip mode is a good way to save the master transcript to use in different sequences. You can also use the transcripts you have in clip mode to build a sequence directly from Transcriptive. So I have these different clips with transcripts, and I'm going to use the Control-I shortcut to add an endpoint, the Control-O shortcut to add an outpoint, and you can see the in and out point added in the source monitor, and then the Control-comma keyboard shortcut to add that section to my timeline. So going through and adding a couple different pieces to my timeline using in and out points. This is basically the same workflow that you would use using the source monitor itself, adding in and out points and inserting to a timeline, but I'm just doing it from Transcriptive. And then when I switch clip mode off and load the transcript for the sequence, it automatically loads a transcript made up of the pieces that I selected. So this is a really fast way to log footage or build a rough cut using Transcriptive. If you make edits to this timeline, either by trimming clips, rearranging them, or adding new clips, you can resync the transcript by clicking the Transcriptive menu and selecting Sync Transcript to Sequence Edit. This will load a transcript that is based on the current active sequence. So you can make a bunch of edits in your sequence and then sync the transcript to the sequence to quickly create a transcript for any timeline that you have transcripts for. Thanks for watching. Check out our Digital Anarchy YouTube page for tutorials on all of the features of Transcriptive 2.0. And if you want a free trial of Transcriptive or any of our other plugins, go to digitalanarchy.com.